A note on Iris. This is an excellent film based on a book about real events written by John Bailey, the husband of Iris Murdoch. Iris is Iris Murdoch, an acclaimed writer and philosopher. Actually, she was a professor of philosophy at Oxford when she met John Bailey, her would-be husband. And she even has a book in the first 100, in the best 100 novels written in the 20th century, as compiled by the Modern Library. Books written after 1920 or 1927 or so, and in the English language. There are other lists. A Le Monde list comes to mind, with more European books written in French on that list. Albert Camus, L'Etranger, and Marcel Proust are on top of the Le Monde list. But then, of course, we can find both of these writers on the Guardian list. Not very properly called the Guardian, because in fact it was compiled by the Norwegian Book Club. They asked writers all over the world from about 100 countries, and some 50, no, I'm sorry, about 100 writers from some 50 or so countries. And a lot of Shijou Tampadu is there, as well as The Stranger, L'Etranger. The film has a fabulous cast. We have Judi Dench as the older Iris Murdoch, and Kate Winslet as the younger writer. John Bailey is interpreted by Jim Broadbent, an outstanding actor, one of my favorites, and the wonderful Hugh Bonneville, better known for me, maybe for other viewers, from Downton Abbey. It's heart-wrenching. We see what happens in the later part of the life of Iris Murdoch, a beautiful mind. Maybe there is a similarity between Nash in The Beautiful Mind and Iris Murdoch here in this film, because they both have an IQ of, I don't know, 200. I'm exaggerating. I think Einstein is supposed to have had 160 or so. And they both have issues. Iris Murdoch suffers from Alzheimer. At one point, I'm thinking of the scene where she's on television. She's interviewed live, and the interviewer is asking about language, about the importance of language. Does it work? Something like that. And the author Iris Murdoch is lost. She's, I think, not there anymore. And then, of course, she has a lot of problems, because her mind is not capable of doing simple tasks anymore. Presumably, we don't really know what's in there, but the acts don't make sense at all. In another scene, her husband is, John Bailey is preparing something, and by the way, it's an awful task for those who have to go through this with their loved ones, take care of them and see them decaying, going down, and it's frustrating and devastating. As well as at times may be rewarding, because for one thing, acts of kindness, positive psychology has demonstrated, are one happiness activity, one activity which brings happiness or increases subjective well-being levels, even if acts of kindness, not when that kindness involves such a thing, I'm saying. And then there may be post-traumatic growth at one point, but that's, I'm going too much into this. So in that scene, he's doing something, and Iris Murdoch is out the door, and she disappears, and he's terrified, panicked. He doesn't know where she is. He's driving around. He goes to this river where there are memories. They went in as a young couple, and people were watching them, even young students, as they were bathing, and Iris was naked. She was a free thinker at one point. I mean, while involved with John Bailey, she had sex with someone else, and he knew about it. He could see, actually. And overall, an extraordinary story with happiness when we see them young and in flow, and emotional and dramatic sad when the writer is sick with Alzheimer's.